Good evening, lovely tubers. My name is The White Mexican, and welcome to Market Watch Investments. I have a plethora of cards that I'll be showcasing for you guys tonight, and I do hope that you enjoy. So getting things kickstarted tonight is going to be Fiber Jar from the very infamous Generation 1 Legacy of Darkness. I wanted to do something a little bit different for you guys today. I wanted to change it up. I kind of wanted to stack themes with groupings, so I'm going to be going over the majority of the more popular jar cards, and then some to a variant of the different viruses, and there's a couple of kind of add-ons towards the end. So it's gonna be a quick little video that I just wanted to shoot for you guys, but I wanted to try something a little bit more organized. So we're just gonna go ahead and get right into this. So this is the original print Legacy of Darkness Ultra Rares. Very collectible, very much banned, and just an amazing recycle factor in general. We're looking at first edition near mints to start off. And these are going for roughly around 39 bones. There's actually a two stack here for the starting market price. And then there's actually only one page of availability. If you want to switch over to lightly played variants, those go down significantly, all the way down to 12 bones. So a significant price decrease on the lightly played conditions for the first editions. And there's actually two pages of availability for that. Really quick, I want to check out bulk pricings. So core TCG holding it down with the only stack one single playset for lightly played first edition for 35 bones. And then if we switch back over to near mints, out of curiosity, it looks like there is one single stack here for near mint first editions for 45. So really incredible stuff for Fiber Jar. Alternatively, there is a, I guess there's not, I'm thinking of something else. So there's the rare from Dark Beginnings, and there's the Legendary Collection 4 Joey's World Commons, which are actually pretty good money for being that they're common. So all across the board, this is worth relatively good money. Just out of curiosity, you know, since this is a common, obviously it's quite a special common because it is Legendary Collections common. But if you guys happen to have first edition near mint lightly plates, again, being that it's just a common, these are worth some pretty good money. About 4 bones plus, so definitely a great sell target. You know, there has to be a buyer, there has to be a place, there always has to be someone who's willing to pay the piper and cash out the bills. But there's a stack here, the starting stack is for 4 bones for 18, and it continues to trickle up after that, so pretty incredible. Definitely a great sell target. Personally, if you guys have that, I would definitely sell that. Alright, so next is going to be Cyber Jar. So this is the highest rarity as the ultimate rare, dawning from the very infamous Duelist Pack Kaiba. Really, really great set. A lot of great cards and high rarities of ultimate rare. And it's going to go ahead and take a look at some first edition near mint price points here. This is what it looks like. Very, very fantastic. Starting market price is going to be around 92 bones for near mint first edition copies. This has had a significant increase in price trends. This is like an all-time high that I've seen for this card. Let's see if there's any bulk prices. There's no bulk prices available for first edition near mint, so we're going to go ahead and take that off and then switch over to some lightly played variants. Again, this is going to be for more collectability purposes, and like 99.9% of my material is always first edition. You guys got to go exclusively for first edition. So that's what we're going to be showcasing today. Lightly played first edition copies are going to be 59 bones starting market price. And let's see if there's bulk prices available for that. There is a single bulk price stack of 4. Lightly played first edition bulk pricing starts at 62 bones. So pretty incredible on that. There is some healthier alternatives, a little bit more affordable, such as the Hobby League 2 Parallel Ultras, which look very, very aesthetically pleasing. I love Hobby Leagues personally myself. And so we're going to go ahead and take a look at these really quick. We're going to start with near mints. Near mint copies, there's actually a stack of 4 here starting it off for near mints for 16 bones, which is pretty incredible. How many stacks are available? So it looks like there's 2 stacks available. It goes from 16 to 18 for the stacks for near mints. And then we're going to switch to lightly played. So again, this is Hobby League, so no need to worry about first edition. First edition was not manufactured for Hobby League, so that's why it's not an option here. And there's a significant amount more for stacks for lightly played. You can see starting market price for a fat stack of 50. That's pretty incredible. I don't know anyone that's had 50 of pretty much any Parallel Ultra Hobby League cards. Pretty incredible. Lightly played 16 bones and trickles up to 17, then goes to 20, then goes to about almost Phantom under 23 after that for stacks for lightly played. So very, very incredible. you take off stacks, roughly around the same price. There's a 2-stack here for about 15. So I think ideally these two are pretty much going to be the ones that are going to hold the most value over long-term investments. But then of course you have the very nostalgic, great, infamous generation one set three magic ruler, which is the original print, of course, and it's all its infamy, which, you know, for a first edition Yearman copy, I mean, I definitely can kind of see potentially that being lightly played. Here are about three bones, give or take. So let's take a look at stacks of lightly played. There's no stacks available for lightly played. Is there stacks available for lightly played or near mint? There is no stacks available for near mint or lightly played, so that might be a corner on the market if you guys have stacks to list. So let's see, near mint first edition copies are roughly around the same. They're around 2 to 3 bones, and again, there's no stacks available, but can quickly articulates value when you get towards the end of the bottom page. Only 2 pages of availability, so something to consider. Next is going to be Morphing Jar 2. So this is kind of a lesser known. This is actually the highest rarity that we have as a super rare holofoil dotting out of a very infamous, very legendary collection, 3 Yugi's World. It's an amazing set. I highly recommend you guys check it out. I talk about this set all the time. I promote it. I love it. It's an amazing set. A lot of just blockbuster cards and amazing rarities. So you guys should definitely check it out if you guys have time. And let's see here. So we're going to take a look at first edition near mints. And these are just a couple bones. About not even 2 bones for first edition near mint copies for these onesie twosie stacks. Let's see if there's bulk prices available. Bulk prices, infamous core TCG, and infamous, I mean that by all paths of manner. I love this store. Almost never mess up orders, and just really, really great archives of cards and all that. So, fat stacks, stacks start at 7 here. Near mint first edition for 3 bones for a stack of 7, leading the way, and then it trickles up after that. Let's go ahead and take a look at the stacks for lightly played, and then stacks for lightly played are going to be about 3 bones for lightly played first edition copies. 3 sets of 3 here for about 3 ETH, but you got to be careful of this shipping here. And then if we take off stacks just out of curiosity, let's go ahead and see again for lightly played. It's going to be a little over a bone, and about 2 bones for near mint again for the onesie twosie stack. So pretty awesome. If you guys don't know what the effect does, you can pause the video, read it. Not most people know what this card does. It's nearly not as infamous and great as its counterpart, the original Fiber Morphing Jar, but pretty cool and great artwork. I really like the artwork on these jars as well. Taking a look at some alternative prints, we have the original variant, which I believe is a rare, yes, so Generation 1 Pharaoh Servant, which is pretty cool. Everything else is pretty much just commons, besides it got a star foil rare out of Star Pack 2014, so that's looks like it's worth a couple bones. But more specifically, if you're not going to be investing in the first edition supers as the highest rarity from Legendary Collection Yugi's World, then I would maybe, out of curiosity, like to see what the near mint first editions are going for. Ones of cheesy stacks, it's just like, you know, 1-2 bones for bulk prices. Apparently there's no bulk prices for these, so these older first edition generation one lower rarity cards are running out on bulk prices, so that might be a corner market for you guys if you have them. But if we switch over to lightly played, there's 2 availabilities here, a 4 and 3 stack, and the starting market price is going to be about 3 bones, and it's going to move to about 2 bones for lightly played. So that's original print, pretty great stuff on that. Next is going to be Morphing Jar. So this is going to be the highest rarity from Tournament Pack 2, which is also the original printing of this card, if I'm not mistaken. I'm pretty sure Tournament Pack 2 Ultra Rare variants are the first variant that were manufactured in the game for us here in the TCG, and this is obviously like pretty much almost unattainable. Insanely expensive, very, very sought after for collectors. There's a PSA 9 here, apparently, for 3,700 bones plus 50 on the side there, so pretty incredible. 3,700 bones plus is very, very incredible. I guess, of course, I'm looking at near mints. Of course, this is tournament pack, so again, there's no first edition, so, you know, just disregard that. And then it quickly goes to almost 10,000 bones after that, and 50,000. So really ridiculous, very, very ambitious price points. I really don't see anyone really selling for these values, even for this PSA 9. 4 grand, almost 4 grand, is pretty incredible. Obviously, there's not a lot on the market, only 3 stacks of 1. We're going to switch over to lightly play just to kind of get the price differentiation. So it looks like it's not too much of a price difference of 5,000 bones here for this lightly played, and about 5,000 for this one as well. So really sharp looking card, really great glossy finish, and it looks pretty great. But you know, all around just insanely collectible card, not a lot of availability because it's just insanely old, hard to get, and extremely expensive. Carries a very, very fat price tag. Another alternative is going to be the super rares from tournament pack 4. These are significantly more affordable, a lot more attainable. So we're going to go ahead and take a look at near mint copies. First onesie stack is going to be about 300 plus, 260 plus 3 for shipping on that. And then starts to articulate after that, and articulate value after that. Can't speak today, apologies. And then there's only one page of availability for this. For near mint, let's go ahead and take a look at lightly played, check the price differentiation, and it's going to drop down to about 188 about for these onesie sacks. There's two sack here for 188, and it doesn't look like there's any availability for bulk prices on either the near mints or lightly plaids. Let's see here. Actually, there is one stack of one playset for 275 for near mint variants of the super rare reprint from TP4, which is pretty incredible. And there's some other cool artworks as well. There is the legendary collection Yugi's World, which again, I'm all over the set. It's an amazing set. First edition ultras, that's a really cool holofoil. And then there's also the OTS pack 9 super rares, which again, I think are really underrated. It is very much an OTS pack super rare, so a lot of people come off like super rares being like mass produced, really cheaply made, and just like mass reprints and just really, really low quality. But keep in mind, this is an OTS pack, an OTS 9. It's relatively an older one, so I think that definitely has potential to grow in time. So just be aware of that. There also is the retro pack rares, which, you know, it is just rare, but it's retro pack, and retro pack is really sought after for collectability purposes. But ideally, there's also a champion pack rare as well, so that's kind of interesting. So because these sets are so infamous and they're really sought after for collectability purposes, I mean, even though they're just low rarities of rare, it's a really old card, a very infamous and powerful card for quite a while. It was on the ban list for quite some time. It's really great that we have it to one now, just like card destruction or hand destruction. I always get card destruction and hand destruction mixed up, but you know what I'm talking about. The magic card, you pitch your hand, you draw as many as you had. But anyway, so really great stuff with this. So there's a lot of opportunity and a lot of different variants that are great variant prints for this morphing jar card. Needleworm is going to be next. So this card, I love this card. I think it's really, really fun. There's like that whole deck out deck that uses this, and I don't know, just a little silly deck that is kind of just fun to play. And obviously this is one of the more relevant cards for that deck specifically. It's just a fun little side deck you can play. This is the original variant, I believe, from Tournament Pack 3 as Ultra Rare. Again, just like Morphing Jar, this is insanely expensive and really high collectability value, hard to get. $2,000 is pretty much going to be a starting market price for near mint variants. It looks like there's two copies here. And they're all pretty much around that range. Here's a picture of it. So nice glossy finish, old school generation one looking tournament pack holofoil. Really great. We're going to go ahead and take a look at some lightly plaids now. Decreases significantly for the lightly plaids to about 641, pretty much all across the board. And again, there's three sets of one on that. And again, there wasn't bulk prices available for that. So pretty awesome. And then of course, just like Morphing Jar, it had the super rare mirrored variant from TP5. And we're gonna go ahead and take a look at some near mints first. And starting market price for the near mint supers are going to be about 52 bones. And there actually is a stack here of 6 for about 6666. Then it goes all the way up to 100 bones for a stack of 3. We'll switch over to bulk prices of lightly played, and those are going to be about 58 for a stack, one stack of 3. And then if we take off bulk prices, there it's gonna go to about 51 for like the onesie twosie stacks for lightly played. So really great stuff on both the tournament pack variants. Also, there is a healthy alternative, which is very much the legendary collection 3 Yugi's World. So again, you're seeing the trends here, a lot of really outstanding reprints in this set. Apparently also the commons are worth some pretty good money too. Not a ton of variants for this card, seeing how insanely old it is, but even the commons are worth some good money. So if you guys don't want to play the commons, I mean, sell them off. Looks like they're worth a couple bones a piece, so that could be a good maybe push off. Personally, I would play with and hold on to the ultra rares, or if you guys, I think the ultra rares, it's nice enough and cool enough to like play, but it's not like anywhere like as collectible as the original supers and ultras, so it's safe to play with those. And they look really great too. Again, the ultra rare finish is really great in legendary collections 3 and 4. Next would be the Shadow Grave. So this is kind of an obscure card. It's definitely kind of seen today. This is an insanely old card. I think the original was from PSV Pharaoh Servant as a rare, if I'm not mistaken. So very much a Generation 1 card. I just love the artwork on this. And one thing I wanted to take note is that the DT variant, so there's obviously a couple variants of this. So the DT3 common variants, these are almost bought out. For near mints, there's only a single stack of 5, which is, you know, a stack of 5, but and it's about almost 3 bones, and then there's just 3 bones shipping here. But for the stacks, at least for near mint, there's not really a lot of availability. That's just pretty much it, and then it's pretty much gone. And then there isn't any options for lightly played. Apparently there is only near mint, and then if we take off stacks, like, that's it. Like, there's just this one listing and there's no lightly played. So I just thought that was really interesting that there's no lightly played on the market specifically for this variant, the DT common, and there's a stack of 5 for the near mint, but then it's completely gone pretty much from the market for acceptable rarities. And then again, of course, there's that original Generation 1 Pharaoh Servant, maybe for the first edition rares. Those are relatively affordable if you guys are interested in that. And I just really love the artwork, like the red sun and like kind of like the sleepy death scythe looking reaper is really cool. A couple commons we just won't really much pay attention to, but I just thought that was kind of interesting. I wanted to give that a little spotlight. So next is going to be me moving into the virus cards. So over the jar stuff, moving into the viral stuff, the virus cards here. I'm going to start out with my all-time favorite virus card. I love this card. I've been playing this since Structure decks of the Underworld and Graffa and Dark World. I'm a huge Dark World player, and I love playing the virus cards with my Dark World builds and blends, and this is just a really great card. I think this is really underrated. The sheer fact that you can just completely eradicate all of your opponent's magic cards or all your opponent's trap cards is really, really strong, especially in Dark World when you can use like Drag Down to the Grave, when you can be like checking their hand, or maybe even, I think it's Mind Crush as well, which is a really, really great card. I love Mind Crush and Call Down to the Grave, which are, you know, infamous in Dark World. Anyway, this is the highest variant, dawning out of Force of the Breaker, an extremely old set, as in a very aesthetically pleasing, amazing secret rare variant. We're gonna go ahead and look at first edition near mint copies, and apparently this has corner wear, slight corner wear, but it's listed as near mint, so it's kind of interesting. But it's a little bit of a reduced price here, about 140. It looks like there's just 2 stack here for 145. There's a Deutsch European, Germany Deutsch European one here, which I'm not even going to begin to pronounce because this is insane, but it looks really, really cool. It's actually a stack as well. We're going to go ahead and look at stacks. It looks like the only stack is that Deutsch European variant with its first Auflage and all its infamy. And we're going to go ahead and take stacks off, and then we're going to switch and check some lightly plaids. Slightly plaids are going to trickle down significantly. They're going to go to about 105 bones. And there actually is one stack here for 180 on the lightly plaids. So again, near mints, you're only going to have the European prints for stacks, and then lightly plaid has a stack for 180. Which is interesting. I mean, it makes sense because it's English, but it's interesting. It's like a less condition, worse condition, but it's English, so I understand why it's more expensive, but it kind of like should balance off because it's a worse condition. But anyway, so really great stuff. Obviously, this is the most sought after variant print. There also is super rare variants from the Duelist Genesis, which is an amazing set. You know, Stardust Dragon, one of the most infamous synchro cards of all time. Really, really great. I think it was a 5D set era, if I'm not mistaken. This is total trash. I would completely just not really consider this. I think the super rares, they're a lot older and they look a lot cleaner and nicer. And personally, it's just white Mexican bias. It's like I crack a lot of jokes about like just being utterly disgusted with ultra rares. So it's kind of a silly on running joke that I have. Commons, not really much to look at, but out of curiosity, I would like to see what the bulk prices are for some near mint and lightly played, because it's going to be for playability purposes. Again, you're not really going to collect these, and seeing that they're only super rares and they're very much special edition super rares, so kind of like that mass produced cheap reprint. But they look really clean, and this card has amazing artwork, and this card is really powerful. For the longest time, this card was at one, I think. Is it still at one? I don't know, I can't remember. I think it's still at one. I don't always keep up with the lists and like the meta games and everything. It's probably something I should probably diversify myself in. But anyway, near mint, fast sack of 40, under two bones, so incredible amounts of availability here. These are all stacks here, so there's plenty available to go around, and just an all-around great card, great alternative for the secret. All right, next is going to be Full Force Virus, so Raging Tempest, really great set. This is the Zodiac set, nice 2016 set. I actually remember at the time I was in South Korea, so that's kind of how I tagline these time frames. Really great artwork, an okay effect, obviously not one of the more powerful virus cards, but really, really cool artwork, high rarity, secret rare. And the best thing about this card is it's extremely affordable, even for first edition near mint stacks. The stacks have trickled down. There's not as many as there used to be. I feel like there used to be like an abundance of this card, and it's kind of gone down quite a bit, at least in like quantity here, but still very, very affordable. There's a couple stacks of three here for roughly around two bones for first edition near mint. So again, it's interesting that the stacks are kind of going away, but this is again for first edition near mints. If we add in lightly plates, it looks like there's a couple more for lightly plates. There's a one stack for lightly plate if you guys want. Again, so there is the mirrored secret rare reprint from 2017 Megatons, but because the original rate core set variants are, you know, so affordable, just go for the original ones. I mean, it's like the same thing with like winter cherries. There's a pretty big increasing price difference between the Megaton one and the Shining Victories one, but still, it's always going to be worth more in the long haul, especially for collector's value, to get the original prints, even if it has a mirrored Megaton reprint. For playability purposes, I'll play with the reprint all day, but for collectability purposes, you always want to go with the original first secret, which, you know, it's going to cost you more, but it's worth it in the end. And then these two are just, you know, for like peasants, so don't really pay attention to them. All right, next is going to be Deck Devastation Virus. This is Dawning on a Flaming Eternity as the highest rarity, as the ultimate rare. Curious to see what the other variants are, because I know that there is several different variants. Deck Devi, good old Deck Devi. Okay, so we'll get to that. All right, so ultimate rares. So we're looking at first edition near mints, of course, as the high rarity of the ultimate rares, the original core set here, which again was Flaming Eternity. There's a stack of two near mint first edition for 400 bones, and then roughly around 400 bones for this one stack. This is Ruxin. I wonder if this is like the actual Ruxin YouTuber who does all the crazy, insanely expensive, old school sealed product crack openings. Anyway, we're gonna do lightly played. So there's two as well, and those are gonna be about 300. So we'll switch over to both, and of course, there's not stacks available. There's that stack of two there for that near mint, but there's a very, very limited numbers of quantity for the highest variant as the luxurious ultimate rare. Looking at some different variants, there was a nice, there's a Dark Revs Volume 3 Super Rare, which is pretty cool. And then there is the original core set Super Rares, which I think is definitely the best bang for your buck, at least for playability purposes. Again, this card just has amazing artwork. There's a Champion Pack 5 Rare, which is kind of interesting. But other than that, these commons and this Trash Ultra is not really much to look at. Out of curiosity, before I move on to the Dark Revs variant, I'm going to look at some first edition copies of this. Near mints looks like they're going for about 5 bones, and then for lightly played first edition variants, they're going to go for about 2, And just out of curiosity, see if there's bulk prices available, and it doesn't look like there's bulk prices available for first edition copies for Lightly Plate or Near Mint. But it's going to give you kind of a rough idea what's available, at least for that variant. And then, of course, there's the infamous Dark Revs 3. So, personally, I of late, I've been kind of getting into and really starting to appreciate Dark Revs. For the longest time, I was kind of the mentality of, like, it's, like, low rarity for high dollar for low rarity. But these are extremely nostalgic sets. I can see why they're really special to a lot of collectors, and they are really cool, and like the packaging and the artwork of Dark Revs and Dark Beginnings and all that, and just like the time frame was really, really cool. So I'm starting to kind of understand their viewpoint on that. So we're going to switch over to Near Mints. There's some Italiano European variants here. Italiano stuff is like taking over the TCGP platform. It's insane. They've just been popping up everywhere. So, obviously Dark Revs, there's no first edition variants, they weren't manufactured. 17 bones for Near Mint for Euro prints, Italian Euro prints, and then English Near Mint copies, there's a one stack for about 21 bones. We're gonna switch over to Lightly Played. There's Lightly Played Italiano variants, and that's pretty much it. So really, really limited on the Dark Revs, which is no surprise. Dark Revelations always kind of has very limited availability. Crush Card Virus is going to be next from the very infamous Duelist Pack Kaiba as the ultimate rare. So as they get errated, they really water this card down a lot, almost to like on pretty much almost unplayable level, in my personal opinion. Some other pretty great variants that I'm going to get to shortly, but we're going to start with this one as the highest rarity. Here's another Italiano, European one. So Near Mint first editions, there's an Italiano one for 125 here, and then the first English prints is going to be 150 bones. And let's check out the Lightly Played first edition variants. So 70 bones, there's a Lightly Played Italiano one as well. And it's going to trickle up after that. And out of curiosity, I'm going to switch back to Near Mint and then check bulk prices. So interesting enough, apparently there is no bulk prices for Near Mint or Lightly Played, but I could have swore I saw a Lightly Played one. So I guess not. It's kind of interesting. Anyway, so that's going to be the price variance for the Ultimate Rares. Interesting enough, another variant that's very, very expensive, very, very costly, is going to be the Gold Series 2008, which I believe is Generation 1, the very first Gold Series here in the TCG. So a lot of great history merit on that, and it looks aesthetically great. Gold Series 2008, 2009 are probably some of my favorite Gold Series. They really did gold right. They had just like that flash of gold, that like little hint plush. It looked really, really nice. This is probably one of the most expensive gold cards. Some pretty crazy trending over here. So for Near Mints, there's a Deutsch European German one here, which, you know, has that pretty colorful name. And then that's going to go for about 230. And then about 300 bones for the first English variants. If we switch over to Lightly Played, it's going to decrease quite a bit. About 108 for Lightly Played English. There is, once again, another Italiano one here. And then it quickly increases to about almost 240, about 238 for the next English Lightly Played. So very, very incredible. Again, these are all one stacks. All these are one stacks, so I don't know if this was like a short print or it was just really hard to pull. The only one that has somewhat of a multiple is this two stack for 300. So really, really great. Obviously it's seen some obscene price increase. So the gold, the ultimate, and then there's a turbo pack one rare, which, you know, is a cool pack, crappy rarity, and that's pretty much it. Of course there's the infamous Shonen Jump Championship Series promo prize card, which is like just pretty much unattainable, but that's also a thing, very, very sought after for collectors. Next is going to be Grinning Grave Virus. So still to the day, this is still a solo print, super rare, out of Lair of Darkness. I love this structure deck. I really regret not investing in this for the first edition sealed structure decks. I'm a big fan of investing in first edition structure decks and just keeping them sealed. Some of my favorites include Shadal Showdown and structure deck Gates to the Underworld. I think I also got several Soul Burner with the common Ash Blossom, which, you know, Ash Blossom is always had interesting plush price fluctuations. And all around, it's a great card. Even for the commons, pretty incredible where the price point is at. Okay, so looking at first edition, near mints or even lightly played. Cool artwork, again, kind of not really anywhere near on par as the original two viruses, Eradicator and Deck Devi, I think it was. Really great artwork though, and it's cool that's a solo print. That's definitely an interesting aspect to this card. There's some more, once again, Italiano, European variants here, for under a bone for near mint first edition, but then English copies are going to go for about 2 bones for bulk prices. Again, I'm looking just specifically for bulk prices on this one. And then additional articulates a couple bones after that, 2 pages availability, so something to consider, maybe, perhaps, possibly. Electric Virus is going to be next. So this kind of just popped up because of, you know, virus in the name. It's not really related to the virus cards by any means, but I think it has really cool artwork and kind of an interesting card. So, like, one of the lesser known hand trap per se. I guess you could consider this a hand trap because you pitch and then off spark and effect. But like how it's a thunder, like how it's a level 3 light. I think it's just kind of like a little lesser known card. Really cool artwork again. I really like this artwork a lot. Just a common from its original core set, which Strike Neo is a really cool set. A lot of really awesome secret rares and ultimate rares in this set. Really, I called it the pink set. It's got this bright pink packaging, kind of like Magician's Force. Very affordable, even first edition bulk prices, like under a bone. What's interesting is there's also a Star Foil rare from the Battle Pack Tournament prize cards, which is pretty obscure. I didn't really know much about this or when this was or anything like that, but apparently it was some kind of tournament prize card. Near mint copies are going for about 18-19ish bones, and then they, for near mints, then they trickle up to about 20 plus, about 23. Even for lightly played, they're still around almost about 17. So if you have it, I mean, I don't know, just hold on to it, maybe go up, but anyway, cool card. Next is going to be Marionette Might. So this is the original variant. I love zombies ever since Zombie Horde. Zombie Horde was another amazing structure deck that I really, really wish that I invested in when it first came out in, you know, in the masses for first edition sealed. But this is just really cool. Obviously, it combos off of Zombie World here. And you can basically just like snatch and steal an opponent's monster for a turn, which is pretty cool. Original variants, even for like first editions, bulks, prices, a lot of availability, and very, very affordable, so not really too concerning. Looking at other variants, that's really like the best variant. I mean, the other two are just, unfortunately, they're all commons, and both of these variants were from structure decks. Interesting enough, of course, zombie structure decks. And then the Strike and Eos was the original one. So, I mean, ideally, this is going to be the best print. And then, of course, there's Zombie World itself. So, this is the Legendary Collection for Joey's World variant. So, I believe this is the second Haunting Dawn Dust, our third variant of Ultra Rare. So, kind of unfortunate that we're getting all, like, these, like, back-to-back rarities of Ultra Rare. Really wish they would have made this a secret rare. This would have been so much better in a secret rare. I think this is a great just anti-meta card in general. You don't even need to really necessarily play zombies to like whip this out. This is very much like Necro Valley. Has really great ties to anti-meta spirit and just completely like disrupting a lot. Really cool artwork. This is the oldest hollow variant, I'm pretty sure. I'm trying to remember. I think the original was just a common from like a really old structure deck, but we'll get into that shortly here. So first edition near mint copies. So even with there being 3 different ultra rare variants now, this is holding still really good money. There's a stack of 3 near mint first edition for about 14 here. And again, there's another stack here for about 14 plus this bone shipping. And if we switch over to lightly played, so there's no bulk prices for lightly played. It looks like there's actually just 1 lightly played first edition for 10, so that's kind of interesting. So not too much of a crazy amount of availability here. 1 page between, you know, spread across LA Plate and near mint. It is definitely the best variety variant in my personal opinion. The Dual Overload Ultra is significantly less. It's a little brighter, which is kind of interesting. And then, of course, we had the ultra rare variant from the second Haunting, which just came out as well. And it looks like, I would say Zombie World, Structure Deck Zombie World was probably the original variant. And then, of course, we got another common from Zombie Horde. So, really cool stuff on that. Next is going to be Puppet Plant, so kind of going off of the virus hand trap there. I just really like the artwork on this. Again, these are very simple, like one-for-ones. This is actually really cool. This is the highest variant as a rare from Turbo Pack Booster 5, which is pretty cool. I just really like the artwork. It reminds me of like a Venus Flytrap with just like, I don't know, like what was like the Poison Ivy, like the chick from Batman, the like sexy green chick, jolly green giant looking chick, but like female version. Anyway, kind of rambling in thoughts here. It's late. I wanted to kind of make this video on the fly, and my mind's just kind of wandering. White Mexican is fading over here. But let's see. So this is about a bone here for near mints, and we're gonna go ahead and look at some bulk prices if there are. So it looks like there's a bulk price here. It's 11 stack for about 4 bones. And then let's see if there's any lightly plates. And there's some lightly plates here, some fat shipping tags on these, but they're significantly more affordable, 80 cents and 100 or 1 bone. So really cool. I mean, I don't know. I just feel like showing this is pretty solid. There's a common, I think, two other commons. Original print was Strike and Neos. Which again, you know, the other one was from that, so it kind of makes sense. And then, of course, just the other reprint common. And the last card that I'm going to be showcasing for you guys tonight is going to be Upstart Goblin. I talk about this card all the time. I do admit I recycle this card a lot, but I feel so passionately about this card. I love this card. This is getting pretty ridiculous. This is actually the original holofoil super rare, dawning on a Turbo Pack Booster 8, and this is just continue to see, you know, some pretty articulate values here. The first most affordable variant for near mints is going to be 80 bones, and it bottoms out all the way at 130 bones plus. Now, these are all one stacks except for this two stack here. If we switch over to lightly played, it's about 69 bones for the first couple. And then there's no stacks available on this one as well. So some credible value in this. I remember when this came out, I actually saw one of my locals in like 2011. I think it was when this set came out. Pull one, which is really cool. Other variants though, there's some other healthy all variants that are more affordable, such as, once again, the Legendary Collection, very infamous, Yugi's World, really, really great. So we're going to go ahead and take a look at the First Edition Ultras. Again, I'm not a big fan of Ultras, but I make exceptions for a small part of the market, and some of the Legendary Collections is definitely very much part of that exclusive pocket that I like. And near mint first edition copies starting market price is only good value, is gonna be about 11 bones, and it continues to trickle up after that. These are all one stacks, by the way. If there's two stacks here, starting market price is gonna be 20 bones for the first near mint stack. It goes all the way to 25 for the fat stack of 11 after that. We're gonna go ahead and take a look at stacks for lightly plaids. Lightly plaid stacks starting market price is gonna be about 15, that's gonna go to 19. And then we're going to look at just lightly plates in general, which they're about the same, pretty much about 11 bones. So pretty much the same as the near mints, specifically for the first edition. So definitely a great alternative. Really love the coloring and lighting in this card. It looks really great. That's personally my favorite variant. I would much rather have several of these than even the super rares personally. And of course, there's the Generation 1 set 3 Magic Ruler Magic Stamp variants, which are really, really great as well. And just out of curiosity, I want to see if there's even bulk prices available for either First Edition Lightly Plate or Near Mints. And there actually surprisingly is. Apparently these have never been played. Magic Stamp Original, really great stuff. And those are 15. And then there's a stack here. This is kind of interesting. Apparently, these are only five. This is a very affordable price point. I'm trying to see here if these actually look. It's kind of hard. It's kind of a bad picture to see if they're original Magic Stamp, Magic Ruler, and all that. About five bones for those, and then three for lightly played. So I'm very surprised. I think this is actually a pretty good amount of availability for bulk prices. We normally don't have a lot of bulk prices for these, so it's pretty cool. Let's see. We're gonna take off stacks. And it looks like there's actually a near mint first edition here for two bones. It's very affordable. And there's a stack of two here. These are actually really, really affordable. I'm very surprised by this, with being if they really are near mint, truly first edition original Magic Stamp variants. That's pretty incredible. Unfortunately, there's only one and two stack, but very, very affordable for those. You know, again, if they really are near mint first edition. So great stuff on that for the OG print. Very nostalgic, very much generation one. And then to close it out for you guys tonight, of course, is going to be something that I talk about all the time, and this is really what I wanted to hone on to. Like, yes, I love the original Magic Ruler 1. Yes, I like the Legendary Collection 3 Yugi's World Ultra Rare. But what really takes the cake is going to be the Super Rare reprints from Secret Slayers. So, Secret Slayers being, you know, an infamous Rona COVID 2020 set, not really too much history merit, still very much a relatively new set, not really too much of a big deal. What's cool about this is it does have the updated Hollowfoeing here on the spell attribute, which looks really cool. Seeing it's a newer card, obviously they moved the first edition down here and all that. But it looks really clean. It looks really great. I honestly have a hard time differentiating between this and the Turbo Pack Super Rare. Obviously, the Turbo Pack Super Rare is older and a lot more expensive, but they look pretty much the same. I think personally this even looks better because it has the updated Hollowfoeing where the spell attribute is Hollowfoeing, whereas a Turbo Pack doesn't. And these are just insanely, pretty affordable. And they haven't really gone up, and it's interesting because they've ranged from when this set dropped. I bought several of these, like bulk pricing, first edition near mint stacks, right when the set dropped, for two bones a piece, and I was picking up left and right for bulk prices for two, because I just think that this card has so many places to go. It's still at one. It's been at one for quite some time. Will it come to two and three? Potentially. I mean, I'm very much an optimistic realist. I mean, it definitely can happen. It's possible. It's not really so much of will it. It's kind of more of when it will. And it just really has great artwork, and draw power is really important. You need draw power to get your combos, and I really prioritize draw power as a player, and it's really great stuff. So we're gonna go ahead and take a look at first edition lightly played near mint stacks. Again, there's still some really great opportunities. Like, there's this fat stack of 90 right here for three bones. There's this single stack here of under two bones, but not really under two bones. It's got this 99 cent shipping, five stack here for about three bones. So it's for over like almost 2 years later, it's really only jumped from about two bones to about three bones. So it hasn't really articulated too much value increase, which I think is very interesting. Just gives you more opportunity to pick it up. I really think that this is one of the MVPs of Secret Slayers. Obviously, this got like completely overshadowed by like Eldritch. That was like a huge deck core from that, the hype from the set. But this is a really, really great card. I definitely recommend that you guys pick up on this. I know personally I've invested quite heavily in this card myself. Yu-Gi-Oh! Has been part of my life for many years. I love the brotherhood, the community, the deck building, the investing. There's so many amazing aspects that go into this hobby, and it's important to have hobbies. Life is just fun when you have hobbies. I would love to hear from each and every one of you guys. My information below is for my Facebook. I love networking and just meeting other players and having discussions and talking to you guys. I appreciate all your support and all your participation. I love your comments. And I really hope that you guys are enjoying this content. I've been working really hard to think of some really creative ideas, and I've been trying to outbranch and network and resource and really try to bring some diverse and unique content for you guys. So I really hope that you're enjoying it. If you are, please communicate that with me. I'm always seeking critical feedback and trying to get better. And that's pretty much it. I apologize. It's super late. I'm kind of like in an off head space right now. So the world's a crazy place. Please remember to love each other, respect each other, take care of each other always, be a friend, be a brother, be a sister. I hope you guys are making some fantastic Yu-Gi-Oh investments yourself. This has been a showcasing by The White Mexican, and I will see you in the next video.